If an alien race were to land on Earth and first experience the Manawe gay pageant, what do you think they would conclude about humanity?
Thank you for that very interesting question. Good evening, Mandawi. Well, if an alien will land here on Earth, definitely my first reaction will be shocked, of course, because it's going to be unusual for me to see an alien face to face. But if that alien will see the Mandawi Gay Pageant, how will that alien conclude humanity? Ladies and gentlemen, as we all know, human as we are, Filipinos as we are, we are a very happy person. In spite of troubles, in spite of challenges, in spite of difficulties that life offers to us, we still survive of that trials. We still survive of that difficulties. So I can definitely say that alien will conclude that humanity is a very happy individual. Because after all, ladies and gentlemen, it's all happiness that matters, regardless what challenges you experience in life. So thank you. I think that would be happiness you will experience.
I have a question. Do you think that legalizing same-sex unions can help control the looming case of HIV/AIDS in the Philippines?
Okay, thank you for that very interesting question. It really brings light to a very serious matters nowadays. Remember, ladies and gentlemen, that marriage or same-sex marriage is the union of the two couples who love each other. Whether a straight woman or a member of the LGBT community, ladies and gentlemen, we can all have HIV, but we need to educate everyone in order for the virus will be prevented. Ladies and gentlemen, if we are all educated enough, I think we could lessen the virus in our society. Ladies and gentlemen, if we are all educated, thank you. If we are all educated enough, I think we can live harmoniously. Thank you. Thank you so much.
If God made everyone in his image, would he approve of a competition like the Mandawi Gay Pageant, which just basically admits that we are essentially unequal and should be ranked by looks and intellect?
Thank you very much for that very wonderful and very hard question. First of all, I would say that God created people. We happy people. And I believe that in beauty pageant, it does not require a gender. And I believe that whatever they say, pageantry is a platform for us, for our self-confidence and self-love. And we are here because we are created by God with purpose. And we deserve the same acceptance, the same privileges and right to have our Miss K pageant in this world, just like anyone else. Thank you.
Greetings, Philippines. A few months ago, boxing superstar and Senator of the Philippines, Manny Pacquiao, invoked the Bible and said that men should dress as men and women should dress as women. What are your thoughts on this, and what would you say to him?
The only thing that I can say to Manny Pacquiao, to all the people, that we transgenders, cross-dressers, the LGBT community, are not even the Bible. Even science couldn't define it. But we are all human beings. We are created in the image of God. So we should have the rights that any other gender should have. We should not put every gender in a box, separate us and categorize us. We should think about the whole society. We should have to live in harmony, coexist to each other, regardless if you are a disabled person, you are a transgender, a lesbian, or if you are gay. It doesn't matter at all, because according to Geraldine Roman, that the law of the land is not based on the Bible, but it is based on our Philippine Constitution. So we have the same right as what you male and female does. And that is all. Thank you.
Hello, good evening, Mandawi. I hope you all are having a wonderful evening. My question for you is this. How can you, as a contestant of this beauty pageant, lobby for the passage of the SOGI bill, which is currently pending in the Philippine Senate?
As a beauty queen, we are the voice
to the LGBT community to gain respect and accept to our society. Soulji is created by people to people. Soulji is created not just for our the transgender, but created for all of us, for us to accept unity. And unity starts with you. You yourself, you have to have unity so that everyone in this world is living happily. Thank you so much.
Greetings, Madawe. Who for you is a better leader for your country? A man, a woman, a transgender man, or a transgender woman?
I think there is no someone out there who is better than to serve in our country. As long as you do have the heart to help the people who are in need, you have the will to help the government, which is currently facing corruption, not just corruption, but the poverty, hunger, and health. That should not be that should not be limited to that gender, race, or even your type of skin color. Then you should be fit of that position. And that would be all. Thank you.